Here are the solutions for test 1-2. Mrs. Menchu is thinking of two mystery numbers. She gives two clues as shown in the table. Clue number one, both numbers are opposites. The distance between the numbers on the number line is 20. Well, it tells me I better draw a number line to solve this. So, first of all these numbers opposite each other? They are. So, clue number one is not important. I mean, they're all relevant. So clue number two, the distance between the numbers on the number line is 20. So if I did negative 5 to 5, how far is negative 5 from 0? 5. How far is 5 from 0? So the distance is 10. It cannot be A. Let's look at letter B. Negative 10 to 10. How far is negative 10 from 0? 10 units. How far is 10 from 0? Another 10 units. That's 20 units. The answer has to be B because the distance from negative 15 to 15 is 30 and the distance from negative 20 to 20 is 40. So how far the distance between negative 10 to 10, 20 units. Question 2. Which statement correctly compares the numbers on the number line? I see negative 1. And I see negative 2.5. What do I know about a number line? On a number line, it goes from least to greatest. Greater numbers are on the right-hand side. So that means negative 1 is greater than negative 2.5, or negative 2.5 is less than negative 1. Negative 1 is greater than negative 2.5. So it must be G is the answer for that question. Question 3. There are 5 numbers graphed on this number line below. Let's first point them out. I see negative 4.5. I see negative 2. I see 0. I see 3. And I see 5. Which of these numbers is not classified as an integer? Oh, what is the definition of integer? Integer is either a positive or negative whole number. Or another way to say it is a whole number and its opposite. I see whole numbers. Whole number, whole number, whole number, whole number. Not a whole number. So which of these is not an integer? What's that one? So it's negative 4.5. So I bubble in the negative, I bubble in the 4, and I bubble in the 5. Negative 4.5. Question 4. Which number is a rational number, but not an integer? A rational number is any number that can be written as a fraction. Fraction. They're all fractions. So far, they're all rational numbers, but not integer. Ooh, how many 2's go in 20? 10. Ooh, what's the opposite of that? Negative 10. How many 4's go in 16? 4 times. What's the opposite of that? Negative 4. How many 4's go in 14? That doesn't go in even. I mean, it's 3 and 2, 4, or 3.5. That's not an integer. And the last one goes in 4. H is the answer. This is not an integer. It's really negative 3.5. Integers are whole numbers, and it's opposite. Question 5. Looking at the set of numbers, which best describes the following? Are they all rational numbers, integers, or whole numbers? So, rational number, any number that can be written as a fraction. Fraction, decimals can be written as a fraction, 3.5, that can be written as a fraction. 13, 1 can be written as a fraction, negative 1 over 1. So they're all fractions, so they're all 1. 1, 1, 1, 1, 1. So they're all correct. All right, let's go to 2. Integers. Integers are whole numbers and they're opposite, positive and negative whole numbers. So, is that a positive or negative whole number? No. So they are not integers. Not all of them are integers. Is this a whole number? No. So I only see rational numbers, which are A. They cannot be whole numbers. They cannot be integers. They are just rational numbers, which are numbers that could be written as a fraction. Answer is A. Next one, question 6. Mark, Chad, Joe, and Steve competed to see who could run the farthest without shopping. Mark ran 1/2, Chad ran 7/8, Joe ran 3/5, Stephen ran 3/4. Put them from greatest to least. So you have a number line. You could draw a number line. Greatest to least. Well, I know half will be right here in the center. So that's half. So we did that one. 7/8. I think 7/8 is closer to 1. It is. So I know that one. But then the rest I don't really know. You know what? Why not just turn them into decimal equivalency? I know half is really 50 hundredths. If I can 7/8 go into a hundredths place, it cannot. We have to divide it. You have $7 or 7 whole, and you want to divide it among 8 parts. So can 8 go in 7? No. Can 8 go in 70? It goes in 8 times. 70 minus 64 is 6. Bring down to 0. How many 8s go in 60? 7 times. The remainder is 4. I add another 0 to $7. Does not change anything. Can 8 go in 45? So 7/8 is really 875,000. If you wanted to round this to the hundredths place, it's either 87 or 88 hundredths. So that's the greatest. 3/4. Isn't 3/4 really 75 hundredths? Because can 4 go into a hundredth? If you don't, here's 3/4. Can it go into a hundredth? It can. It goes in 25 times, which is 75 hundredths. And then the last one is 3/5. Can 3/5 go into a hundredth? It can by multiplying by 20. So 3/5 is really 60 hundredths. So the greatest seems like it's 875,000 or 7/8. So it's either F or G. Then the next greatest is 7,500, then 1,600, then 50. Answer is G. That is the greatest, the least. So what I did is turn them into all into decimals. You can also find the least common denominator if you like doing that. I like turning things into decimals. Question 7. Put these, the table shows the different temperatures, or so it said 5 different days. Put them from warmest to coldest. If you had a thermometer, isn't warmer getting away? So all the way up here. So we're looking, oh, it's greatest to least. The greatest number. Let's start with a positive number. We know positive numbers are greater. So we have 11. These are the positive numbers. Isn't 11 and 5 tenths really 11 and 50 hundredths? 11 and 2/3. 2/3. What is the decimal of equivalency of it? You know what? I'm going to divide it. So 2 or $2 divided into 3 parts. Can 3 go in 2? No. Can 3 go in 20? 6 times. 20 minus 18 is 2. I bring down 0. Can 3 go in 20? 6 times again. It repeats. So really, this is 11 and 66 with a repeating bar. If you really had to estimate, it's 11 and 66 hundredths or 11 and 67 hundredths, depending on how you do it. But we just want to leave a bar. So which one is the warmest? Well, that's the highest. Thursday. A is wrong. So it's either B or D. The next highest is 50 hundredths, then 45. So the answer is D, 11 to 6600, then 11 to 1500, then 11 to 4500. I didn't have to look at the negative numbers to solve this. Number 8, Magdalena has 24 cans of soda and she wants to share equally with 8 friends. This is G9. Oh, equally means divide. Which expression cannot be used to find the amount of cans each friend will receive? So it's really 24 divided by 8. And which one? You could also write 24 divided by 8. All these mean the same thing. The only one that does not make sense here is F. How are you going to divide 8 cans? No, it's cans divided by people. So F doesn't even make sense. No, 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 no. 24 divided by 8, 24 divided by 8, 24 divided by 8. Question number 9. Joseph uses tiles to represent integers as shown below. Which one shows 2 groups of negative 4? Well, negative 4 are the black. So that shows two groups of negative 4, which is negative 8. A is the answer. So it's two groups of negative 4. A is the answer. Question 10. A shark swims at a depth. Here's the ocean. Here's a shark. It swims at a depth of 275 feet below the sea level. So here's a shark, Mr. Shark. Looks like a fish, but mirror, shark's not a fish. After sighting a whale, hungry, a shark moves 190 feet closer to the surface. Says hungry. Here's a big fat whale. Another big fish. Again, not a fish. It's a mammal. So it goes up 190 closer. Let's use what we know. First of all, what integer represents a shark new depth? Where is the shark going to be now? Is he going to be 465 feet above the sea? No. He needs water. So we know these two don't make sense. It's either G or H. So how much will he have to go up? So it's negative 275 plus 190. Do we have more negatives or more positive? We have more negatives. That's why we decide it's G or H. So how many more negatives do we have than positive? Well, let's subtract this to see which one is. Let's see, 5 minus 0 is 5. I'm regrouping here. That is 17, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. 85 feet. So we have 85 more negatives than positive. So the shark went up 190. Now where is he? He is at negative 85 feet. Question 11. Which of the following equals or simplified? The word simplify, it gives me find the solution, find the value. What's the answer of it? Which one equals to negative 1? Ooh, I love singing my little song. Well, let's do multiply and divide first. Multiply or divide, it's an easy thought. Same signs are positive. Well, there's no different sign, so stop singing. I'll save you my thing. All right, so what about subtraction? Oh, subtraction. Oh, I like that one. Change the minus to a plus, change the sign of the next. And then all you do is add them up as if they were a plus. Well, think about it. If I have 39 negatives with 38 more negatives, that would be, that's like 77 negatives. Well, so far, I haven't found the answer. Maybe it's 3. I have 19 positive, I have 20 negatives. I have one more negative than positive, so the only answer is 3. That's the check X. The only answer is, X. The only answer is 3. All right, next one, question 12. Simplify the expression. In other words, again, please answer this. What is the absolute value of negative 5? 5. If you have 25 negatives and 5 positive, what do you have more of? I have more negatives. How many more negatives do you have? By 20. So I bubble in negative. I bubble in 20. The answer is negative 20. Question 13. Mr. Lewis plants a daffodil bulb that has a diameter of 225 meters, which shows an equivalent length. They want us to turn it to a decimal. What place value do you prefer? I like hundredths place. Plus, most of the answers in hundredths place. Not all. Can 25 go into a hundredths place? Yes, by 4. So it's 8 hundredths. How do you correctly say, ooh, I know it's not A or wait, this is 800, this is 8 tenths. B is the answer. To check your work, let's turn this 800 back into a fraction and simplify 450 to 25th. That is the answer. That's 8 tenths. That's really 4/5. Question 14. Each of three students wrote an equation, blah, blah, blah. Which of these wrote an equation that is true? Let's start with the first one, 5 and 2/8. 5 and 2/8 is really simplified 2, 5, and 1, 4. If you remember anything, I don't know, you remember this from fifth grade, to turn a mixed number, which is a whole number of fraction, you multiply the denominator with the whole number, 4 times 5 is 20, plus 1 more is 21 4. Or another way to do it, if you don't like it that way, is let's divide 21 by 4. So that's 5, bring down 0, decimal, get 4 going 10 twice, bring down to 0, get 4 going 25, 5 and 25 hundredths, which is the same as 5 and 1 4. So Nicole is correct. So which of these are correct? So it cannot be H, so it's either F, G, or J. Eric wrote 5 and 14 hundredths. Let's simplify that. 5 and 7 fiftieths. Is that the same thing as 21 fourth? We just did 21 4. So 5, we just write it. It's right here. 5 and 2500. Is that the same as 5 and 1400? No, Eric is not correct. The only answer can be F. And definitely this one's not correct. 4 and 1 fifth is really, well, first of all, we already did. What is 21 fourth again? 5 and 2500. This is 4 and 1 fifth, not even the same whole number. Good job, Nicole. Which of the following is not equal to 1 and 4 10? So let's go to the first one. What is the opposite? Remember, it's negative on the outside, I mean opposite. What's the opposite of negative 14 10? It's 14 10. Is 14 10 the same thing as 1 and 4 10? Let's see. It is, because how many 10s go 14? One time. We have left 4 10. It is equal. So this is true. We're looking for which one is not true. What's the absolute value of negative 1 and 40 hundredths? 1 and 40 hundredths, which is, can be written as 1 and 4 tenths. So that's true. Maybe it's C. What's the absolute value of 14 10? 14 10. What's the opposite of 14 10? Negative. Stop the press. The answer needs to be positive. But here's the answer is negative. The answer is C. And 1 and 4 tenths simplified to 1 and 2 fifths. So that's why C is A. All these are positive except for C. 16. Oh, I love these. Oh, quadrant 1, 2, 3, and 4. What type of numbers do you see in quadrant 4? If we start at the origin, which is the home base, which is 0, 0, I must go right. Right of 0 are positive numbers. Then I go below, on the y-axis I go below, which are negative. So it has to be H. Start with positive and end with negative. X and Y. Question number 17. Which ordered pair lies inside this polygon? It has to be and also in quadrant 4. Ooh, even harder. It has to be inside this shape and in this quadrant, quadrant 4. Wait, stop. I'm going to go back to 16. What are the characteristics of quadrant 4? Start with a positive and with a negative. Can't be A. Those are two negatives. Maybe B. Can't be C. Those are two negatives. So it's either B or D. So it says, starting at 0, which is the home base, I go 3/4. From 0 to 1, there are 4 parts. So 1/4, 2/4, 3/4. So I go right here. I go down 1/2. 1/4, 2/4, which is 1/2. I think that's the answer B. That is inside that polygon and it's in quadrant 4. If you try to grab this one, you go 1/2, 1/4, 2/4, which is 1/2. You go below to 3/4. 1/4, 2/4, 3/4. It's right here. It's tad bit outside. That's why it has to be B. And last but not, and 18. Jana surveys the students in her class to determine their favorite custard flavor. Here are the results. Which statement is true? First of all, let's count out how many people are in this class. 8 plus 10 is 18, plus 2 more is 20. There are 25 kids in this class. Let's see. How many like vanilla? According to this, it said 8 people out of 25 like vanilla. 8 people out of 25. Ooh, I think that's true. But how is that the correct decimal of it? You go into the hundredths place, times 4, times 4, 32. Hey, 32 hundredths, 3200. I think the answer is A, but I'm not sure yet. Just making sure. First, I'm gonna start right now. Is 2/5 really equal to 20 hundredths? 2/5 in the hundredths place, it times 20, it's really 40 hundredths. I'm not even gonna read B. I already know that's not even make, doesn't even make sense. All right, next one. 1/5 is 5 hundredths. 5 hundredths simplified to 1/20. That doesn't even make sense. And D, 8/10 simplified to 4/5. But it says 225. That doesn't even make sense. So the only one that makes sense is A. 3/200 does simplify to 8/25. And a bonus, if you choose to do the bonus, going back to question 18, what decimal of students do not like strawberry and chocolate? Let's see. Here's strawberry and chocolate. These kids do not like strawberry and chocolate. These kids do not like strawberry and chocolate. They like vanilla and lemon. That's 10 kids out of 25 who do not like strawberry and chocolate. So what decimal is that? Let's turn to the hundredths place, times four, 40 hundredths or 40 hundredths do not like strawberry and chocolate. So this is test 1-2.